Right, so I'm going to jump right in. Now, let's talk about Meg Thee Stallion. Now, the story we may have concocted together to make a real narrative of what happened the night with her and Tory Lanez, seeming like this is just not the story at all. Now, Meg is speaking out about it, and she's saying that she was not in a romantic relationship with Tory Lanez. She also stated that she kept quiet at first to protect her friends. She said, I was recently the victim of an act of violence by a man. After a party, I was shot twice as I walked away from him. We were not in a relationship. Truthfully, I was shocked that I ended up in that place. My initial silence about what happened was out of fear for myself and friends. Even as a victim, I have been met with skepticism and judgment. The way people have publicly questioned and debated whether I played a role in my own violent assault proves that my fears about discussing what happened was unfortunately warranted. So I'm just a little confused because it even seems as though he was trying to put out the narrative that they were in a relationship when you heard some of those songs on his album. I'm not going back to the album, but y'all could go and figure it out if y'all want. But, you know, people are saying that Tory is going to jail. So we'll see what happens moving forward. You know, we're going to have to find out one way or another. Do y'all think that she was really in a relationship with him?
I mean, if she says he wasn't, I mean, they weren't, I guess they weren't. But, like, somebody in this situation is sick and twisted. And right. At some point, it's going to come out who it is because both sides of the story are so vastly different than the other person's side of the story that, like, somebody lying and they lying hard.
That's scary. Yeah. Well, let's move on. Some people thought that this was scary, and I was actually shocked by it as well. Now, Angie Ann sent me a profile of this young girl. She looks she's a beautiful young girl. Well, come to find out, she's Bin Laden's daughter. Okay?
Wow. So she says.
So she says. So she calls herself Baby Bin Laden. Now she's on Twitter. And she's a beautiful girl, y'all. She looks to be around 22 years old. And she did say this one thing. She said, my father was good to me and was always a good father figure. I will never tarnish his name because what he did was none of my business, nor was I involved. Now, she had to be about 2 years old when 9/11 happened. But she has merch that said Bush did 9/11. So I don't know, guys. You following her or what?
Probably not. I don't want to be on no terrorist watch list.
Facts. I just thought it was interesting that she's an influencer. Like, she has a really strong following.
She's beautiful, actually.
Yeah,
she's
pretty. You know, she seems like your average young person out here, you know, popping on the gram. And then it's like, wait, you didn't know you were following Bin Laden's daughter? And she's like, yeah, I'm out here. And she said she's going to put receipts out soon because people are calling cap on her. So
we'll see it. And we also know that you say what?
She fine.
Let's just move on.
If I was a young dude, I'd have me some little terroristic babies out here.
Said that Bin Laden had a lot of kids, so we might see more profiles popping up. Anyway, no disrespect to anyone. Let's move on. But Ashanti, of all people, why Ashanti? Now, according to the streets, I can't believe this. I feel like she picks the worst relationships. Ashanti is supposedly dating Flo Rida, y'all.
Whoa.
Now, let me tell y'all. Now, Flo Rida is said to have a one-year-old son he reportedly refuses to meet, but they were cutting up on the dance floor last night for a birthday, and it was a private little get-together, so they was like next to each other. So people are saying that they're together, but I don't know. She must really like Apple Bottom because, you know, Nelly and then the Apple Bottom jeans, boots with the fur and all that. Anyway, let's move on and talk about Ryan Henry from Black Inc. Oh, my gosh. Chicago, that is. Now, he is messy, y'all. Supposedly, he is getting called out for sleeping with his best friend's baby mom. Child's mom, girlfriend, whatever it is. As he was suffering and damn near on his deathbed fighting cancer. Listen to what the best friend had to say, child.
If it happened once, say y'all was drunk, you don't know what happened. Even twice, and y'all, after that second time, we knew we were wrong and we hated it happen. Trust me, man. Like, that's my brother to me. She's my son. Mother, my son is everything to me. I would have been willing to, like, work through that. But you guys had sex probably, like, I think she, like, over 20 times, a year and a half. And you, all those messages and all those texts, not one time that anybody say, like, we should stop this, you know?
Oh, ooh, yeah, he need to let her go. That's it. I think you need to let that relationship go, sir. Time to move on.
Even when he beat cancer, Ryan threw a party for him with the baby mom, and they were both standing on each side of him, and he was thanking them for getting him through his pain.
Oh.
Yikes. This is so nasty. Either way, Ryan came out and was basically like, oh, we can both sleep with whatever chick and still be brothers. Well, that's not how it sounds on this side. Anyway, we're going to ask what you think about this whole situation. Has anybody ever messed you over, a family member or anything, and you've gotten back to being cool with them? Would you be friends again with somebody that's done something?
I don't know if we're going to still be brothers, yo. Like, I feel like he broke the bro code with that. Because yeah, it seems like they're in a full-on relationship.
Yeah, you got to leave them people alone. Anybody who will come that close in your circumference and lie to your face and smile in your face and act like they truly down for you and be doing that behind your back, man.
And they call me bro? Like, listen. We still bro? What?
We are the Morning Hustle.